polar fleece. This one I have cut out for a little girl. So this is something that might be fun for you to do. It takes about an hour to make the whole project. It costs somewhere between $5 and $10 to make it. So it's not only quick, but it's very inexpensive. And to cut this out, you first of all have to find out what that child's measurements are. Now, because this has no shoulders, it's just all one piece here, and these sleeves are out straight, it can grow with the child, and that's nice. And if you want it to grow, then you just make those sleeves extra long and roll them up a couple of times for this year, and they can get next year out of it too by rolling the sleeves down a notch. What you need to do first, though, is decide how big this child is. And so if you would just measure from the child's wrist to wrist, just across the top, have her or him spread out the arms and just measure that, and that's the width this is going to be, plus give it a couple of extra inches maybe on each side so that you can have the roll-up cuffs. Well, I've measured that amount that I wanted for a second jacket. I've measured that out on this fleece down here, and I marked it first of all. This is just a real quick marking with chalk wheel is how I first marked it, and then cut it up afterwards. Now what's going to happen with this is that when you cut it and fold it, it has very little involved. You know, there's just very little to this. What I have done after I cut it, or before I cut it actually, I folded this down and decided, okay, this is how wide I want the sleeves. That's going to be the body of the jacket down there. And so all you need to do is cut at the bottom of the sleeves here on both sides. And you don't cut it all the way across, of course, or you've got two pieces, and this whole coat stays in one piece. So what I am going to do instead is just cut it as far as where the torso starts, where you want the body measurements of the jacket to be. And then with the rest of it, this folds around. I've cut here so that the sleeve is separate. This folds around then, and I've cut this far enough so that I can not only have this come to the center, but also I have enough here to fold back for a facing, and here I have a little chalk mark where the center is going to be. So I have enough of this to fold over, so there's going to be an overlap for buttons and buttonholes or however you want to fasten this. I'll do the same thing here. And this side does the same, and this one's going to be a boy, so I'll fold it that way. Okay, then what I also have cut out here at the center is the neckline. It comes up here, and then I have sort of this teardrop look so that it works out just right for the neckline. And what I still have to cut out over there is the other parts. Now notice what I've done here. I've put this shaggy collar on, and what this collar measures is whatever it measures around your neckline. Just measure there and around, stand a tape measure on end and measure all that. This one just happens to be 20 inches, so I need a collar that's 20 inches long because it's going to surge onto there. There are two places after you get it all cut out and put it together to serge. So very quick and easy, and then some machine stitching to do after that. The only places you'll serge are right here under the arm to make the sleeve, and you can see that's been serged on this little jacket. And then the other place is when I cut out my collar, which is here, and I cut this one out narrower because I don't want that shag on this one. I am instead just going to do some stitching probably. So this will go around and it'll be stitched to this on the serger, wrong sides together, and I'll just serge this all around here. And after it's all fastened with the thread, then it'll flip over and you won't even see that line of serging. This is the collar. Now there's something else you could do with this collar instead of this one is about 4 inches wide. If you would make it real wide, think about what could happen back here. Instead of having a fold over collar, it really could become a hood if you'd rather. This one I said was 20 inches long. If I'd make it about 10 inches high, and if I would in fact put a zipper here, just open a zipper and put it along here, then that could open for a big, big collar, or it could zip up and you could have a hood there that fastens instead of a collar. So there are a lot of choices. You put your ingenuity into this and see what you can do. Then besides that collar that we have here, we also need to have little pieces of something to fasten the top and bottom together. That's where they meet, right down here, and where this bottom part meets the top part. You don't overlap them at all, or you'd have a sunken chest in it. What you do instead is just butt those edges together, and you can see over here on the jacket where I've zigzagged some of this together. And as they were just touching each other. And then after I zigzagged it, then I put this piece on the top just a solid piece at that time. I cut all the shag later. So it was just a solid strip that was on top here. And I stitched part of that so that it would be stitched on the top of the jacket, the other part on the bottom. So I not only have the zigzagging, but I have also this piece of fabric that strengthens the two and makes sure they hold together. Now, instead of doing that fabric, if you wanted to, you could use a braid or something commercial, just something to cover up and hold the two together is the idea of it. And after I had that all done then, I went ahead and cut all this shag. And that's just a matter of, here's some that I still have uncut. That's just a matter of cutting. Oh, this one was about every fourth inch. I cut up to the stitching line so that I had that, and I did the same thing around a collar. Anytime you want to cut a straight line like this or cut a fringe in a straight line, if you'll just do a little chalk line right here where you're going to cut, then you make sure that as you cut right to that line each time, and that makes it nice and uniform and very easy to do. Some other things that I have on this little jacket then are pockets, and these are very plain. All I did to decorate this a little bit, this is why I could make it easily within an hour, less than an hour, because I didn't do really anything to decorate this. And so as I cut it out, I used pinking shears, or you could use a rotary cutter instead with the pinking blade in it, and I cut around the edges that way to give it a little bit of something extra for a little girl. You perhaps wouldn't want to do that for a boy, make it plain or make it something different. Now remember I said I fold it under this facing here? That has to be stitched down at some point. So you can see I have a couple rows of top stitching here to hold it in place. And also there's going to be a little loop here for the toggle buttons. Now usually toggle buttons have big holes in them. So what I've done to my toggle buttons is first just fold a piece of fleece in half, and don't try to make it a little narrow piece because it's too difficult to control then when you stitch it. But to make it strong, I wanted to stitch it instead of having just one layer of it. So I had a bigger piece here originally that I stitched, and then after stitching it, then you can just trim off the extra real close to your stitching line. Because this is bulky and because it's thick and textury, you aren't going to be able to turn a tube with this. So it's better to just cut it off short, and it looks fine as it is pulled through the button, and then it's the tube of fabric that's actually stitched onto the coat, and the toggle button's loose enough that it's easy for that child to manipulate through this loop that's over here. And they can button it.